Both teams have sent their special teams onto the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. He'll return it from the one. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Taken down at the 19. The defensive end was the victor on that play as he bolted in to tackle him for a loss.
And he was able to do that because the interior linemen held their ground, leaving the runner with no options.
Second and 14. Ball on their own 19. And he's tackled around the 48-yard line.
Anytime a defense brings pressure like that, the most important aspect isn't just the quarterback and the receiver and their execution. It's the offensive line and their communication. Even pre-snap read, okay, here, if this blitz is coming, I've got to pick up him. And I thought that time they recognized the blitz, they communicated very well up front, everybody picked up their assignment, and it gave the quarterback the time to be able to read that defense and make that throw.
Second and 14.
Second down and 14. Ball on their own 44. They come out in a five-wide set. Now he tries to buy some time. The ball pops free. They fall on it. That's a big break for this defense.
You know, this offense just can't afford to be getting hit with the turnover bug. They need to hold on to the football.
So the offense will come out for their first possession.
Good field position for their first possession of the ball game. Let's see if they can capitalize off of it.
He throws a dart to the right. He almost had it, but it's incomplete. The Redwolves always have guys that are near the top statistically, and that's no exception today. We're really looking forward to watching this kid play. From the 41-yard line, it's second down. He's under pressure, and he can't get away from the pressure.
That's a loss of 7 yards.
Third down and long coming up here. Ball on the 48-yard line. Fires out quickly to the tailback. They'll bring him down around the 46-yard line. Well, he caught it, but it's almost no yards gained, and now it's fourth down.
Give props to the D here for coming up with a big stop on third down.
This is a very questionable play call here. I'm not sure I agree with it. Tackle made at the 25.
Lane on the tackle at the 25-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. Fire He's taken down at the 19-yard line. Houston picks up 6 yards with that grab.
That'll make it 2nd and 4.
So it's 2nd down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Brought down at the 23-yard line.
That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
Man left.
He's scrambling. Just throws this one away.
You can bend a bit as a defense, but when they're this deep in your own territory, you just can't break.
4th down. They're going to try a long field goal here. Arkansas State could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks away. And he got it. Reese Davis is standing by with this update. Reese?
The Aggies entered the day ranked 4th. That is now in the past tense. How far will they fall? There is no room to take anything for granted in college football. When you do, it bites you right in the keister. Mississippi State grabs the victory by a field goal. In another game, the Buckeyes came into today's game ranked number 1 in the country. Boy, are their critics going to have a field day after this performance. And for Michigan State, they've won 8 games on the season. Old Sparty gets the victory, 24-17.
Reese, 3-0 here.
The Red Wolves.
They line up to kick this one away.
Number 2, back to return.
Williams fields it at the 1. Tackle at the 24-yard line. Arkansas State's really got things working right now for them. I can't think of a better start.
Well, that's exactly the way they had hoped to see this game go. I mean, anytime you can start the game with a stop, get your offense out there, they move the ball down, put points on the board. Now it's just more about trying to maintain what they've already created.
The defense forced a turnover on downs on the last drive.
That stop gave this defense some momentum last time out. It'll be interesting to see if they can keep that intensity on this drive.
And he just gets rid of it. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 24. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And they make the stop around the 29-yard line. Nice pass there, and the quarterback was under a lot of pressure from the defense.
Here's a safe play hitting the underneath receiver, but it's a nice gain of 5.
Throws, and it's incomplete.
They looked a little sluggish on that series. I'm curious to see if they pick things up when they get the ball back.
4th and 5.
White, back deep to return. He's to the 40. He makes it to the 42-yard line. Quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Arkansas State is up by 3. Play action. Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked.
That was textbook coverage by the defense. That's exactly what you want to do on every single pass play, but it doesn't always happen.
2nd down, 10 to go. Ball on the 42-yard line. Pitches back. He makes it to the 42-yard line. the 42.
No gain on the play. Fourth down.
Ferguson is the punter. He's out to the 30, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 35.
Let's get some points going right now. Not a lot of offense here in the opening quarter.
I'm with you. I'd like to see a lot more offense than we've seen up to this point. Give credit to the defenses, but I think you're going to see both these offense coordinators get more of a feel for things and start to adjust their play call.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan.
And a quick throw. Inside the 30. Tackle at the 12-yard line.
At about the 11.
He's tackled at the 14-yard line.
Loss of 3 yards on the play. Third down.
From the 14-yard line, third down. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
That makes it fourth and 12.
Louisiana Monroe is down three and looking to tie it up. It's up, and the field goal is good. Ready to kick. White fields it at the 2. And down he goes at the 27-yard line.
Boy, neither offense can find any kind of rhythm so far, Herbie.
Yeah, it almost feels like the two offenses are just kind of feeling their way right now, allowing both these defenses just to dominate the game.
They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing.
There's a play fake. He lets it go, and he stays in bounds to make the catch.
That's a gain of 31 on the play. First down.
And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10. Nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
Got a man. Watch out here.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play. What are you
from the 15-yard line. First down. Gets around three on that toss to the halfback.
That makes it second and eight.
From the 12-yard line, second down. He makes it out to maybe the 10-yard line.
Gain 2 yards. That'll make it 35.
He's going right.
You know, as a defender, anytime you're not going to have a chance to get to the quarterback, one of the things all defensive coaches try to teach their defense is to get your hands up and try to knock the football away. And that time, that's exactly what they did to set up this fourth down.
It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Nice run up the middle. Defense stiffens on fourth down, and the ball will change hands.
This time the offense isn't successful on fourth down. The defense had that option play snuffed out from the get-go.
I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation.
He gets rid of this one. From their own 6-yard line, second down. They'll knock him down for a loss.
Loss of 2 on the play.
So at the end of 1, 3-3 tie. Even first quarter as we head into quarter number 2. They keep it on the ground and a great tackle right there.
Loss of 4 on the play.
Not a good spot to have to punt from either. How about that for the defense coming through?
You get the lead, you get the ball back, and now you've also got momentum on your side. I'd say that's a pretty enormous play.
They'll bring him down at the 46.
With 1 quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
Arkansas State is up 2. Scrambling around. He's got it with room to run. Excellent open field tackle.
The pass was a little bit high, but this kid had no trouble adjusting and making a great play.
First and 10. Ball on the 26-yard line. Inside give. Runs it left for a decent gain.
Gain of 4 yards. That makes it 2nd and 6.
It's 3rd down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Nice run to the left there.
Running the option on 3rd down is perhaps a risky call, but the defense didn't look totally prepared for it, and they gave up the 1st down yardage.
Taken down around the 3-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards. That makes it 1st and goal.
1st and goal from the 2, and they can smell the end zone. Arkansas State holds just a 2-point lead. And he's tackled around the 5-yard line. It's 2nd and goal. Ball on the 5-yard line. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Gives it right side. Nice run there as they work the outside.
That makes it 3rd and goal.
Here's the 8th play of the series. Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line D.
Set. Blue 14.
Touchdown, Arkansas State.
This kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
Here's the extra point that'll make it a 2-score game. And he converts the extra point. Let's check in with Reese Davis in the studio.
Let's head down to the Bluegrass and see what's going on in Lexington. Missouri gets the W, 31-7.
All right, thanks, Reese. Ferguson looks ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
I think this defense has played well enough to be able to win this game, obviously. But at some point, you'd love to see their own offense feed off of some of the confidence that their defense is playing with. Because up to this point, the defense is keeping them in the game, but the offense isn't quite doing enough to be able to build on that lead.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. He's got it out to his tight end. Across the middle, brought down around the 35-yard line.
No gain. That makes it 2nd and 10.
Let's go. he's hit before he can go anywhere. He's taken down right around the 48-yard line. Gets it off as he's hit, complete. They'll bring him down at the 44-yard line. A 4-yard loss.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
Second and long. Ball on the 44-yard line. Setting up blockers, or running backs got it on the screen. And they make the stop at about the 49.
With the tackle at the 49-yard line. That'll bring up third and eight.
Throws middle of the tight end. Tackle made at the 33-yard line.
If you're the defense, who do you try to cover this guy with? He's too fast for most linebackers. He's too big for most corners. You have to rely on your safeties, who generally aren't very good in one-on-one coverage.
Quick pass going back to his running back. There's a very impressive open field tackle.
That'll make it second and four.
A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Quickly incomplete. And there wasn't anyone in the vicinity.
I think the ball just slipped out on him.
That'll bring up third and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Throws left, picked off. And he hits him hard at the 24.
Boy, just when it looked like they had a chance to get right back into this game, they throw the interception. Now, it's still early. Let's see if their defense can bail them out.
From their own 24-yard line, it's first down. He might have a chance. And he's brought down at the 37.
That's good for a gain of 39 yards. First down.
Let's see now how the defense responds to giving up the gain on the run. He's in trouble. That's a great tackle. That's the 45.
A great defensive end in college football just pins his ears back and has, again, that extra instinct to know when to jump the snap count, when to take a chance on third down. And it seems like they almost save their extra pass rush and extra incentive as far as their energy when it really matters on a third down, when they feel like they can beat that offensive tackle and get off the line of scrimmage a little bit quicker. And that's something that I think we've seen him do throughout this game.
Strike to his receiver, no good.
Accuracy is such a vital part of being a quarterback. You've got to have an ability to lay the ball right into your guy's hands.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 27. Knight
Off the fake. Quick toss. He almost had it, but it's incomplete. Nice play by the defense to bring up fourth down.
Yeah, instead of going for the interception, they did the safe thing, and that was just to tip it away.
Williams is back to receive. Very high punt. The Birds better watch out. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You know the offense will be looking to do better this time out.
The game is in danger of getting out of hand early. It's very, very important that they not only hang on to the football this drive, but they also need to get a score on the board as well.
Tackle right around the 20. They need to do a better job of managing the clock here.
You're right, Fred. Not only was that a horrible play in terms of yards picked up, but also, as you mentioned, in terms of all the time that may be wasted.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 20. Got some open field. He's tackled at the 32. Bounds at the 27-yard line.
Loss of 5 yards on the play. That makes it second and 14.
From their own 27-yard line, it's second down. Here they come. And down he goes, right around the 38-yard line. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. The Redwolves taking their first time out of the half. The Warhawks wide receiver down there on the sideline. Looks like he's warming up. Good to see that he might be able to get back in this game. White, back deep to return. White fields it at the 30. Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds.
Gain of 21 yards. First down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. He gets to about the 31-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 14 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Got to admire the intensity that these linebackers bring to the table. As soon as he saw it was staying on the ground, he made a beeline for the ball carrier.
From the 33-yard line, it's second down. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Quick throw, and he's got his receiver again. And he's taken down at the 13-yard line.
First down.
They'll spread the field with five wide. To the end zone, intercepted. Big opening.
With the interception.
Just when it looked like this offense might be able to put this game out of reach, you turn the football over with an interception? Boy, this could come back in a big way to bite you.
From their own 25-yard line, first down. He's to the 40. Gets out to around the 48. Don't go anywhere, folks. It looks like we might have a pretty good game on our hands after all. The Red Wolves lead it by 9.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. Arkansas State's played with a lot of energy in the first two quarters, and they're putting a scare into this team that was a heavy favorite. Oh. They're up by a couple of scores right now. Can they hold on and make this an upset?
Can they maintain it? It's a lot easier to come out jacked up and come out emotional and play really hard, but then we've seen those better teams that are deeper, they can rotate guys, they wear you out, they throw body blows. So I think that's one thing to watch early in this third quarter. If they can extend this lead even more, push it out a little bit more, make the other team play even more out of their comfort zone. They're already playing spoiler, but we know this. You know this as well as anybody, Reese. It's a four-quarter battle. There's still 30 minutes to play, and they got to answer the bell because those different waves and that depth is going to show on the other side.
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 23-yard line. They're ready to begin another drive. Is out and the ball is up for grabs. Here he goes. Touchdown.
It always makes you nervous anytime a defender tries to pick up a fumble and run with it instead of just falling on it. Man, did it work out for him here for a big-time play in the score.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick.
Right after return.
He's to the 20. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. The Warhawks have really surprised everybody in this football game.
They have not been intimidated at all, which is great to see. The attitude and effort of this team's put them in a position where they got a shot to win this game here in the second half.
This offense has got to try to pull it all together now after the fumble cost them 6 points just moments ago.
I know as a quarterback, it's always hard to watch the defense score a touchdown on you. But it was always a reminder to take extra care of the football.
Almost intercepted.
Hey, that's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up and something good may just happen.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line. Arkansas State is up 2. And he's hit immediately.
This is why it's so important to have success in running the football. It forces a defense to prepare for it, and then that creates chances on play action. They executed that one perfectly.
From their own 43-yard line, first down. Wants to go long and does.
You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 47. He wants it all, going long. He is drilled at the 27.
You can chalk that one up to the hundreds of passes the quarterback has thrown to this receiver in practice. These guys know and trust each other, and you can see it in the way he threw that pass.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receiver.
Number 23 was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Arkansas State with a two-point advantage. It's caught, first down, and he's out of bounds.
That's a gain of 17 on the play. First down.
From the 10-yard line, it's first down. They're in the red zone, but that doesn't necessarily mean points. Last time, they got intercepted. And he's tackled at the 8-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
This is the 9th play of this drive. Quick to an open man, he dropped it.
Plain and simple. If he doesn't come in with a hard hit to knock the ball free, that's a touchdown.
Coming up third and 8.
So we're looking at another third down here. Taken back a yard.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
And here's a fake. He's taken down at the 6.
What a boost it is for this defense, knowing that they kept the offense off the board. Although in this case, the offense kept itself off the board by electing to go for it.
This coach is one of the most aggressive play callers out there, but sometimes I do think he takes it a little bit too far.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
And he's level at the 9. Receiver in a hurry. They'll bring him down at the 20.
They'll move the chains for another UL Monroe. First down.
goes down quickly.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That makes it 2nd and 2.
Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete.
Number 3 was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
It's 3rd down and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks.
Four down.
Up the middle for a nice game. The catch and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss.
Number 37 tackles him for a loss at the 28-yard line. That makes it 2nd and 14.
From their own 28-yard line, 2nd down. He's got to throw it in a hurry. Tosses left. Intercepted. And he tackles him hard at the 45-yard line. And just a great interception by the cornerback.
Well, that's big time. He made a great read on the quarterback and got in there for the pick.
From their own 45-yard line, 1st down. Arkansas State holds just a 2-point lead.
You know, at that point, I think, Brad, the quarterbacks are just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make a play and the defense got you, just give up on that play and get ready for the next down.
Zips it to the back. Get up. Brought down at the 42-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. They bring him down.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
After the sack, it's now 4th and long. Ferguson to punt. Signals for a fair catch.
Fair catch made at the 26-yard line.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
That makes it 2nd and 10.
From their own 26-yard line, 2nd down. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Here comes the pressure. He's to the 40, fires it out. And they make the stop around the 44-yard line. He's tackled immediately after the catch.
Loss of 4 yards on the play. That makes it second and 14.
From the 48-yard line, second down. And he throws it away. The Warhawks saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action. That's a great tackle at the 44-yard line.
Wow, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
Fourth and long here after the sack. White, back to return it. He's out to the 30. He's tackled at the 32-yard line.
At this point, you got to think about changing something, whether it's the play calling, whether it's the quarterback. This offense is not doing anything right.
The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out. Arkansas State is up two. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. And they push him out at the 26-yard line.
42 yards. First down.
First and 10 following that big run. Let's it go. Intercepted. It's the junior corner.
Number 31 makes the interception.
Boy, I bet he knew as soon as he released that football that he shouldn't have made the throw. And that's the thing. When you're under that kind of pressure, it takes away that one split second you need to scan the area so you know where it's a safe throw.
First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. He's under some heat. Caught with room to work. Tackle made around the 42-yard line.
That's good enough for another Monroe.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Brought down immediately.
Pretty nice pickup here. These guys are getting very tight on their timing.
That'll make it second and four.
Gets to about the 34-yard line.
Gain of two on the play. That'll bring up third and two.
He's taken down around the 16-yard line. Throws it in a hurry. And down he goes at the 2-yard line.
They'll make the sack. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
That's three down and one to go. Arkansas State's leading by two. Great three quarters of action, tight ball game, and now it's the fourth quarter, and this will decide it. He makes it out to maybe the 7-yard line.
Gain of three on the play. That makes it third and goal.
Throwing right.
Hawkins, the intended receiver on the play. That brings up fourth and goal.
Fourth down. This isn't much more than an extra point.
Let's go, let's go!
The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call.
False start, offense.
These offenses have just got to go back to the drawing board. Whatever the
still
coordinators drew up this week clearly is not working right now. The uprights. Forward, ready to kick. Taken from the 10. Heading for the corner. He's out to the 30. He's knocked out of bounds at the 39. The Red Wolves have just not been able to get that offense rolling at all today.
I think they're confused. I think it starts up front with the offensive line. They're not having the typical game that you'd expect to see from them as far as communication. I think it's affected the rest of the offense.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. He's tackled right around the 42-yard line. From their own 42-yard line, it's second down. Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. He's at the 40, at the 30, to the 20. Touchdown, and now they're in front.
You love to have a home run threat like him in the backfield. Every time he touches the ball, he's capable of tearing one off like that.
So the kicker's going to stay on the sidelines. These guys will try for a two-point conversion. This defense not wanting to give an inch here. And they won't get the two.
Doesn't sound like much to complete a pass for 3 yards, but being in front of the end zone with points on the line makes it a much tougher proposition.
Ferguson has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep.
Williams back to return.
Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I love the competitive spirit that we're seeing out on this field today. It looks like one team has the upper hand, and then the other comes right back in to be able to regain the lead. It's going to be an exciting finish.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. And he hits him hard at the 20-yard line.
Called a loss of 5 yards on the play. That'll bring up second and 15.
From their own 20-yard line, it's second down. He gets sacked on the play.
Loss of 2 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and long.
Third and long, and they could really use a big play here.
Let's go.
Throws complete, big loss.
Called a loss of 6 yards on the play. That makes it 4th and long.
White is the deep man awaiting the return. White takes it at the 47, and he's tackled at the 40-yard line. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Pulls it in, first down, and he's knocked out of bounds.
Call it a gain of 18 yards. First down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 22. Complete touchdown. And a nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
One of the things a quarterback's looking for before the ball is snapped on a post route is to see if he has one safety in the middle of the field. Because with one safety, you can use your eyes to move that safety and then throw back the other way for the touchdown. I thought the quarterback that time did a really good job of managing that safety and eventually making the throw for the touchdown.
Arkansas State ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals, I've been watching the defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
Tackled for a loss.
Tackles him for a loss. Call it a loss of 1 yard on the play. That'll bring up second and 11.
Tight right. Four down. No, check that. We're going right here for two, right here.
he's pushed out of bounds. Gain as he works the right side.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That'll make it second and four.
Tackles him hard at the 40.
That is a loss of 4 yards. That'll make it fourth and six.
White awaiting the return. Made at the 38. The Redwolves are ranked high nationally in yards per game, and after today, I can see why.
Well, there's really nothing you can do to stop this offense. If you load up to stop the run, they throw. You sit back, they can run. And that versatility has allowed them today to have a huge performance.
And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it 2 touchdowns in 2 possessions.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And the one thing is that any defensive coordinator will tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. There he goes. Brought down right around the 10-yard line.
Gain of 11 on the play. First down.
A quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Touchdown, Red Wolves. Well, a quarterback just showed us he can beat you with his feet as well as his arm.
And what a dangerous weapon this guy is.
And he hits the PAT. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
The Wildcats were ranked 18th. After that face plant, they'll be lucky to be ranked at all next week. And for Arizona, they've dropped 2 straight. UCLA takes a 14-point victory.
All right, thanks, Reese. Back to the live action here. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff.
Williams deep to return.
He hits a line drive here. Williams from the 10. He's taken down at the 30 for Arkansas State. They're really getting after the quarterback tonight. This defense has been bringing the blitz and is having success getting to him.
And on top of the pressure, they've also come up with the 2 takeaways.
They're still allowing the passing game to click.
Yeah, the secondary and linebackers aren't able to make a play at the point of catch a lot of times.
The defense wants to dig in here to avoid any letdowns. Their last drive broke down and they punted. What do they have in store this time out?
New Mike 52, Mike 52. Set, Sam, 10-19.
Motion, 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 motion.
Hey, hey.
Quick throw. He's taken down at the 39-yard line.
That's a gain of 9 on the play. That brings up second and 1.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. He's at midfield, and they make the stop at the 29.
You know, Brad, I know this game is out of reach, but I just love to see that these guys haven't given up. And there's more to a game than just thinking about winning and losing. As a coach, you want to see your team not give up and continue to try to go out and execute.
He's going right. He's hit and taken down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Slings it. From the 6-yard line. Second down. Pass to the tight end, but he bobbles the ball away.
That was textbook coverage by the defense. That's exactly what you want to do on every single pass play, but it doesn't always happen.
Quickly, and they got it. Touchdown. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
They got great concentration from everyone to connect on that flag pattern. And he converts the extra point. Down at the 34-yard line. The Redwolves having everything going their way right now. They have put up 20 straight points on the board. This offense just torched the defense through the air with a great passing attack on their last drive.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
Nice run to the outside.
That's a gain of 7 on the play. That'll bring up 2nd and 3.
Louisiana Monroe just took their first timeout. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on 2nd down. Just over 2 minutes in the game. And down he goes at the 24-yard line. And that run will move the chains.
Oh, boy, that was a tough one to give up for that defense.
Decent pickup. The Warhawks using their 3rd and last timeout.
Man left, man left.
It's 2nd down, 6 yards to go. Ball on the 19-yard line. Gains around 3 yards on the option play.
Great play here by the freshman safety. He read the run and made a good tackle.
It's 3rd down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Nice run, and he's brought down.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That makes it 1st and goal.
Down!
Arkansas State. The ground attack has iced this game with that touchdown. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Ferguson has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I don't think you can say much about playing defense because neither team is.
Well, it's fun to see this. I mean, it's great to see the points and the offense. I wish we would have seen it early in the game because this is already a game that's out of reach.
The offense now will take the field, and they hope to have the same success they had on their last drive.
You know, this offensive coordinator's got to be feeling so good about the execution that he's seeing from his quarterback and his wide receivers. Because, again, they put so much time into trying to put a plan together. And to be able to see that actually come into play makes you feel pretty good as a play caller. The defenders played the snap count perfectly. They found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
The spike will stop the clock. We've got third and long here. Ball on their own 17. Just over a minute left. Catches it and hit immediately for a loss.
That's a loss of 5 yards. Fourth down.
White is back to receive. They'll bring him down at the 42. So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. Takes a knee. It's second and 12. Ball on the 45. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Favorite play in football of your quarterback. Take a knee. That's the end of the ball game, and our final score in this one, Arkansas State 39, Louisiana Monroe 20. Let's get Kirk Herbstreit's final thoughts on this one. Herbie, what do you got for us?
There was no doubt who the better team was today, Brad.
Louisiana Monroe did a nice job of hanging in there against a far superior team, but in the end, they just didn't have enough to get it done. They played well, though. Nice job, guys.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.
Okay.